Ecce How One Becomes What One Island. By Friedrich Nietzsche. Audiobook 3x8. Ever so slight a tendency to laziness in the intestines, once it has become a habit, is quite sufficient to make something mediocre, something German out of a genius. The climate of Germany, alone, is enough to discourage the strongest and most heroically disposed intestines. The tempo of the body's functions is closely bound up with the agility or the clumsiness of the spirit's feet. Spirit itself is indeed only a form of these organic functions. Let anybody make a list of the places in which men of great intellect have been found, and are still found, where wit, subtlety, and malice constitute happiness, where genius is almost necessarily at home. All of them rejoice in exceptionally dry air. Paris, Provence, Florence, Jerusalem, Athens. These names prove something, namely, that genius is conditioned by dry air, by a pure sky. That is to say, by rapid organic functions, by the constant and ever-present possibility of procuring for oneself great and even enormous quantities of strength. I have a certain case in mind in which a man of remarkable intellect and independent spirit became a narrow, craven specialist and a grumpy old crank, simply owing to a lack of subtlety in his instinct for climate. And I myself might have been an example of the same thing, if illness had not compelled me to reason, and to reflect upon reason realistically. Now that I have learned through long practice to read the effects of climatic and meteorological influences, from my own body, as though from a very delicate and reliable instrument, and that I am able to calculate the change in degrees of atmospheric moisture by means of physiological observations upon myself, even on so short a journey as that from Turin to Milan, I think with horror of the ghastly fact that my whole life, until the last 10 years, the most perilous years, has always been spent in the wrong, and what to me ought to have been the most forbidden, places. Naumburg, Pforta, Thuringia in general, Leipzig, Bale, Venice. So many ill-starred places for a constitution like mine. If I cannot recall one single happy reminiscence of my childhood and youth, it is nonsense to suppose that so-called moral causes could account for this. As, for instance, the incontestable fact that I lacked companions that could have satisfied me, for this fact is the same today as it ever was, and it does not prevent me from being cheerful and brave. But it was ignorance in physiological matters.